In this video, I like to show you how to get the leftmost derivation and the rightmost derivation for a word in a grammar. Here we have our grammar, and you usually have the production rules and the third and the start symbol on the fourth place, or maybe the other way around. Here we have the start symbol at the last position, and it's the S. I will start with the leftmost derivation. We begin with our start symbol, and to derive those words we have to apply some derivation rules. Here for S we have two rules: either S derives to ASB or to the empty string, but because the word is longer than the empty string, I will go with the first rule. So with this rule, I'm replacing S by ASB. Now this is where it becomes interesting, because we have different non-terminal symbols that we could use for further derivation. And because we are doing the leftmost derivation, it means that we have to proceed with the leftmost non-terminal in the string, which in this case is the A. So I will apply this rule and replace the A by the small a, by the terminal A. And the others, whatever was here, I just copy it. Well, I could do it in color too. Well, it was not the color. This one, I think. But I hope it will not confuse you if I have to apply the rule once more. So I will just stick with that now. Now, because we have the leftmost derivation, I am still going to apply the rule to the next leftmost symbol. In this case, the most leftmost non-terminal is the S. And because the word is a little bit longer, I will apply this rule once more. So here we have the A that was already there. Then instead of the S, I write everything what's on the right hand side of this rule. So A, S, B. And then I copy the B that was already there. And that's how I proceed. Now I have to apply proceed with the leftmost A, and I will replace it by a terminal A. So this A was the one I had before, and I replaced this A by that terminal A, because I applied the rule, and then I will copy whatever is there. Then, because I know that the word will not be longer, I already have my two A's. Now I will replace the S by the empty string. This S by the empty string. The S is my leftmost non-terminal. And the empty string, that's nothing, so I'm not writing down anything here. I just leave the S away. And then BB, which was already here. Now I will replace the leftmost B. So in the next step, I'm sticking with those two A's. Then I will replace the B by those terminal B. And I will keep the B that was already there. And in the last derivation step, I will replace the B by those terminal B. And I'm left with the three terminals I already had. And the B I got because of the replacement. And here I derived the word from the grammar. Now let's do the same thing with the rightmost derivation. Again, I start with the S. And the first rule I apply is S expands to A as B. So I will replace this S by A as B. Now, because we are doing the rightmost derivation, we will proceed by replacing the B because it's the rightmost non-terminal in the string. And here now I have A and S that were there before, and I replace the B by those terminal B. Then, because I'm doing the rightmost derivation, now I proceed with the S, and I will replace it again by ASB. So, I have the A that was left before, it's left from before. Then I replace the S by ASB, and I've got the B that was there before, that was behind the S. Now I'm still doing rightmost derivation, so I will proceed with the B, which is now rightmost in the string, and I will replace it with this rule by a terminal B. So I get AA, S, it was left before, from before. I replace the non-terminal B by the terminal B. And I'm sticking with the B that was behind it. Now in the next step, I accidentally changed my brush size. Now I will replace the S by, I will apply the other rule and replace the S by the epsilon. Because if I would use the other rule, then my word would become too long. I'm just showing you the successful derivation for this string. Now I will replace this S. So I keep A and A that were left from before. Then here there will be nothing added because I replace the S by the empty string, so I just write down nothing here. And I just keep the two B's that were behind the S. Now I'm still doing rightmost derivation, so I will now proceed with this A. So I'm keeping the A that was already before that. I replace this A by the terminal A because I applied that rule. And I will keep the B's that were there from before. And then in the last step, again I will replace this A by the terminal A. And I keep the strings, the terminals that were there from before. And now, this is a derivation for the same word in the same grammar, but the first variation was the leftmost derivation and the other one was the rightmost derivation. And, well, that's all I wanted to show you in this video.